Hi everyone, I'll try without the microphone as well, and I will try in English. Hope I will do okay. So I'm Dorit, I'm an architect and an engineer. I have a specialty in historical constructions actually. But today I'm here to tell you about IOTA, which is the brand that I'm part of for the last year. And you're probably asking the architect and brand that is based on crochet knitting, what's the connection? Well, first of all, Shuki and Liron just talked about architects joining with brands that are about furniture, all about furniture, and well, actually it makes sense in my mind now also. But I will tell you a little bit later how I found myself in IOTA. It's really big honor to be talking here about IOTA today. This Italian design week. I'm thinking about our connection. Of course, Italian design is a great inspiration for us. And actually, our name is based on in Latin, which is it means a bit in Latin. And we are based on bits and pieces of the elements that create all of our designs. And I will show you that shortly. Also had to do a lot this was the starting point for the design. So crochet was actually kind of random. Shula liked to knit, she said crochet, and that's where they started. But while they were researching the subject, they understood that actually crochet had a lot, and actually knitting had a lot of logic, because knitting is an international language. There's signs that you can actually explain to anyone how to knit. And it could be someone in Italy, someone in Africa, someone here in Israel, or someone in the United States. You don't really have to have language. You can actually bridge on any gap in communication by just knowing these signs, which are international. This, another thing that they did while actually researching this crochet was making a bank of more than 100 pieces that were made out of crochet knitting. Shula knew how to knit, and she taught Tal how to knit. And together they created like this bank of flowers and elements that were knitted, and to try to understand together what is the base for our designs and our brand. The first thing Tal did when she saw the whole collection was she made them into these black and white drawings, because she said this actually made them a little bit more easy to envision as something modern, something innovative. So this was the beginning of the crochet, and now the next step was to understand social business. How can we make this social? What was really appealing was the opportunity to actually use this knitting as an opportunity to skill other people and to create empowerment by this skill. Everyone has to be, or everyone can be, good in something. And that makes you feel like you are special. I'm very good with cooking, so I'm a great cook. I'm very good with knitting, so I feel like I can be really proud of myself. And here's an opportunity to teach women to be great knitters and to make beautiful, beautiful, beautiful elements. And that was very appealing. So we started to look for communities which we can find women who cannot work outside of their home for any cultural reasons, and teach them how to knit. Because knitting is something you can do inside your house, and base all of our production of all of our elements in houses of the women who we teach how to knit. We were thinking about several communities in some places in Israel, and we found that the Bedouin community in southern Israel has a rate of 85% of unemployment within women, because they are actually not culturally are not able to go outside of their home environments or their villages in order to work. So this seemed like an opportunity, and that led us to Chora. Chora is a village in the south of Israel, which actually has the largest social business in Israel today, which is catering. It caters warm lunches to schools around the south of Israel. They opened a catering kitchen in Chora, and the Bedouin women come and cook for children around the south. They make 9,000 meals a day. They open opportunities for Bedouin women to work in their home environment. So we took ourselves to Chora, and through this catering company, we found women who wanted to learn how to knit, and taught them how to knit. We did two courses in Chora, and the second course was actually very, very successful, and today our production is made in. And we have our knitters that are there. We teach them how to knit our elements, and we send them the work, and they send us back next step after finding our social line was to open up our studio. We opened a studio here in Tel Aviv and started to find our design inspirations, our design route, and to understand how we actually take everything that we have until now and make it beautiful, innovative design. We were thinking about a few directions. It could have gone to fashion. The direction was going in this soft furnitures and furnitures that are based on textiles, and our textiles being the main part of our furniture. These are sketches from the beginning of our work process. This image here is actually a top view of the stool. I will show you later how it looks nowadays after it has gone through all of our development process. While deciding on our route of being soft furniture, we understood that a large piece of our innovation process has to be the textile itself. The textiles that we could buy weren't interesting or inspiring enough, and we had to understand how we can design the textiles themselves as a part of our design process. So we started to create our own yarns. The design process of creating the yarns themselves also created prototypes of the furniture. So what you see here is one of our first rugs that we created, which was actually made a mistake. We started creating these type of yarns, which are actually knitted in a hand knitting in a small manual machine. I will show you the machine in a few minutes, but we made sort of a mistake, which created this green and after that pink and yellow and blue. But when we were knitting this piece, it created sort of an expressionist painting. That's how we felt, which was at the base of a lot of our design. So the textile was becoming a very, very big part of what we were doing. So today we create our own textiles. We have three types of yarns that we create, and are actually based on colors that we chose, and we are mixing these colors together to create more complex colorings for each of the pieces. As this was coming along, our staff expanded. That's how I got into AYOTA, and also we have a textile designer working with us. I was actually sharing the studio with Tal, just because we are friends and we were sharing the studio. But I was swept into this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful thing that was happening next to me, and I finished all my architecture work that I was doing at the time, and started working with the other girls on this because I just fell in love with what was happening in the studio. These are the machines that we are working with today, creating all of the types of yarns that we are working with. This is actually a manual knitting machine, which is you work with it like this, but we put a little engine that does this work for us and creates our yarns. Here's another example of our yarns. And another example of the yarns that we actually work with for our first collection. Now I got to what came out of it. This is the first collection, which we presented in a few design fairs last year, and we hopefully will be at the Shibuya in 2018. This is the first piece. This is our swing. It was the first piece that we ever made, and felt that the like a soft seat, which is also made by more or less 150 of these flowers, which are assembled together. And all our colors are based on a few colors that are put together. This, for example, is black and blue that are together. If I go back, these are two types of blues and two types of pinks, which are sort of together into the yarn that makes this. This is the detail for the blacks and pinks of these flowers. Another piece is a stool which has a rug that makes it the seat. The rug can actually be spread out or be folded, thank you, on top in order to make a larger seat. I hope you can see the fringe that is finishing here and here. This is made of one single yarn. I mean, if we can imagine in our head, the knitter gets a bag with a very, very big ball of yarn, which we make for her, and she just knits it together until this piece is done. This is another rug that we made. But you see here that the colors are changing, but we found a way to make it easy for the knitters. The yarn is actually one yarn that changes colors, and she just has to knit. She doesn't have to change the colors in order to get to this design. We design the yarn in the way that she just has to knit, and then the color changes where we want it to change. And the pillow, which is created the same way, more pillow. Another rug, which is based on more greens. This is a detail of one of our rugs. And here, I hope that you can see that this is maybe a pink, but in this pink you can find yellow and purple and a little bit of blue. All of our colors are very, very complex, and it's part of what we believe makes our designs special. This is just a pack of our rugs, one on top of the other. As I said, we were shown in a few exhibitions in New York in 2016. Very, very well there, and we hope to be there in the next year as well. And we just started selling our pieces in London, in Germany, and in Spain, in several stores. And we are now on the verge of expanding ourselves, hopefully also to Italy and here in Israel, of course. And the last thing I would like to show is a short film.
Can you please tell us once again the meaning of iota in Latin?
Yes, of course. The meaning of iota in Latin is beat.
Beat.
And I hope it's clear that we make little bits of pieces of elements, and together they create our designs. That's the initial